What's the matter, Adam? I see that today you seem happier and smile more than usual. Can you share your joy with me?
Yes, I'm feeling very happy. Retribution. Indeed, retribution. Karma is coming.
Ha ha.
I don't understand what you're talking about.
Harry and Meghan Markle are facing severe reputational damage after being labeled wingers and grifters following a snub from a Hollywood executive. A Spotify executive, Bill Simmons, derogatorily referred to them as fucking grifters and suggested their podcast series should have been titled The Fucking Grifters. This came after Spotify dropped Meghan's podcast after one series. Do you think this could be the kiss of death for their career in Hollywood?
You might have hit the nail on the head there. Hollywood is a tough place, and everything is judged. When you start being assigned words like grifters, it not only affects the way people work with you, but also affects your entire personal image. If Meghan hadn't married Harry, she wouldn't be anyone, because she married Qua Charles's youngest son. Using the royal title, Meghan and Harry have the opportunity to win lucrative contracts with Netflix or Spotify. But they themselves ruined their reputation. To be more precise, they ruined their own food, who foolishly left the royal family, abandoned royal responsibilities, and participated in interviews defaming the royal family. They destroyed their image as quickly as possible. You know, after being called directly by such not-so-gentle words, royal commentator Lee Cohen highlighted that this negative portrayal has spread widely, leading to social media backlash and making the couple a target for ridicule in Hollywood. Through jokes and cartoons, this terrible label is a stark contrast to their royal family origins and is likely to affect their public image long term.
Can you further analyze the fact that Spotify CEO Bill Simmons is not afraid to offend like that? Why did he make such a strong move?
The answer is very clear. This came after Spotify dropped Meghan's podcast after one series. What does it prove? If those podcasts don't work, that means they're terrible. And Spotify wasted a lot of money on useless people. They are completely talentless and incompetent. Isn't that the reality?
That's right. I don't trust their abilities at all.
To be honest, many people wish to be like them, but cannot. Harry was born with a golden spoon in his mouth. What's now? Just keep going like this, and the iron spoon won't suck on either. That all the pair have done since deciding a life in America was better for them than working for Harry's family as ambassadors for the UK, in particular abroad, seemed too much like work for them. Instead, they run Harry's family down for cash, finding most of it was made up. Or half a truth is the same as a lie. It's the wrong road pretending to be victims. Not knowing your true capabilities is also a mistake. The knowledge that Meghan and Harry should know is that to conquer Hollywood, you don't just need a pair of feet to enter, but you need to equip yourself with the armor of passion, talent, and perseverance. Starting from training at prestigious art universities or taking intensive classes to hone your skills, you need to build a wide network of contacts where every handshake can open doors. A new door. Don't forget that in this fiercely competitive world, patience and persistence are the keys to helping you survive and prosper. At that time, you will not only be a player in the game, but also the one who writes its rules. Standing in front of Hollywood, ask yourself, are you ready to make your mark on the map of the entertainment industry? Do you see what Meghan and Harry have in hand other than delusion?
To be honest, do these failed so-called stars in Hollywood do anything other than give themselves awards, which no one has ever heard of?
No! No! There never was a Hollywood career. It's what she was desperate to achieve, but she was not a good enough actress. She did not receive the rapturous welcome she had hoped for from the celebs and Hollywood stars she expected, particularly as she had invited so many, whom she had never met, to the wedding. Virginal white dress and veil and so on for what was at least her third wedding. The first was to a young man she met at college, Joe Giuliani, who divorced her with the support of his parents. Then Trevor Engelson, who had his own film producing business but would never employ her. Then Harry, who at least would give her the fame and fortune she was after. She has failed at every venture she tried, with no talent and no work ethic. Ah! I think she believed that being a member of the royal family entailed living in big palaces and castles with staff just hanging on every word, always ready to fulfill her demands. Glittering state dinners, glamorous events, premier, lavish holidays, and staff always at the ready to meet her demands are what she expected. Royal duties include visits to different parts of the country, shaking hands with local dignitaries, visiting local businesses, and so on, and opening new village halls, watching school games and competitions, and visiting hospitals and sick children, and so on are the bread and butter of royal commitments. She found all this boring and was heard to exclaim out loud that she was not getting paid for this. A worse person to join the royal family would be hard to find. None of the kindness, graciousness, or interest shown by Catherine, Diana, and others holding royal positions. Thank goodness she didn't stay.
As far as I know, Meghan lured Harry away from the family, betraying the family with the promise of becoming an A-list Hollywood star, earning billions of dollars, and dominating the world, far surpassing the wealth of the royal family. But things are going in the opposite direction and facing many challenges. So do you think Harry is desperate and a lot of arguments are going on in their marriage?
I'm sure everything you just said is happening. Harry left everything behind, including his family and his luxurious, carefree life, to follow Meghan to America. Now, not only do they not receive lucrative contracts, but they are also heavily criticized. They are humiliated. Soon they will decide to divorce. I think so. You see, Harry, if you weren't so hard up to marry just about anyone who walks the streets, you wouldn't be in the situation you put yourself for disrespecting your family's wishes and letting that stray dog in the streets where you found it. Furthermore, their delusions know no bounds. Meghan wants to be a rock star without first being any kind of musician. First, she has no experience to back up her wannabe trade empire, nor enough professional experience to host a cooking show. Nobody starts at the top. Nothing works this way.
I completely agree with what you said. It seems we get along very well. That's why, after many discussions and working together, I still feel excited and interested.
Really? If so, that would be great. I hope we can continue to get along well like that.
Do you know what our greatest commonality is?
What is it? I still haven't thought of it. Passion, enthusiasm.
That's almost right. Okay, let me reveal it. That's why we are all anti-fans of Harry and the royal family, right?
Ha ha ha, so funny. Actually, I'm someone who learns a lot about the royal family, and now that it has become my job, I learn even more thoroughly. That made me understand these two crazy people better, making me frankly hate them. They don't deserve to be respected and treated like humans. They are both evil, despicable, and cruel. If there are words that are worse than, I'm ready for them. They treat everyone badly, not sparing anyone, including parents, grandparents, and children. Using the word disappointment is too mild to express my attitude towards them.
I also had a similar experience. I'm sure I understand your feelings, but it's okay. They are so done. People are sick of them. They really have sunk to the lowest of the low. As I said at the beginning of the video, it is karma and retribution.
When all this started, Meghan was still a very young girl. What she lacked was talent. But the real problem is her attitude and the way she uses people whom considers to be of no use and them discards. Since they went back to the U.S., she's obviously had too many procedures, as seems to happen once people start, and is looking pretty rough. The way she scrapes her hair back to enhance what she considers her peerless beauty doesn't do her any favors either. This is getting silly now. They are the target for all the failed journalists and Autobots. What is their latest whinge? Anyone know? Other than trying to ingratiate themselves in the public or celeb perception and by award appearances. Clearly not working. They are like those clueless lottery winners we can't help following.
So what do you think are the achievements that Meghan has achieved until today?
It was successfully deceiving Harry. Simple as that. her most remarkable achievement. The rest is very difficult. I can't think of anything, but on the contrary, her failures are countless. They really haven't achieved that much of note. They got the deals because of the titles. Sadly for them, instead of grabbing the offers of a lifetime that not many other people would get, they chose to use it to attack their families. But it's the lies that the pair of them have spread that creates the dislike. All of this boils down to one thing they didn't get what they wanted, which was half in, half out. They wanted to live for 6 months a year in the States and use their titles to make money for themselves. They would return to the UK for a few months of the year and join in with what we call the big family gigs. Not only that, they wanted the role of being the global representatives of the monarchy. When they hit publish on the Sussex Royal website back in the UK, without any of it being agreed beforehand, it shocked the UK and also shocked the monarchy that they could be so underhanded. Only they got a shock when the Queen didn't fold to save face and grant them their wishes, which she couldn't have done anyway. What people don't realize with the monarchy being our head of state, they have to work closely with whatever government is in power at the time. The Sussexes announced to the world that they were people of international importance, IPP status, and as such, the British taxpayer would continue to fund their security across the globe. Only they forgot to ask the government if it was okay with them first.
Do you think if they regret it, will they be forgiven? And do you want to give them any advice? And what about watching this video? What do you think about this question? Please express your thoughts below in the comments section.
How can I say it? In our world, it is never too late to turn back, but it will not be easy and will require a lot of effort on their part. They need to be willing to face and accept previous mistakes and then slowly rebuild. To say that receiving forgiveness immediately is impossible. The pain and damage they cause is too great, so they need perseverance. I think it's important for them to reestablish their relationship with the public and the media. And more importantly, admit your mistakes to your family. Ask for forgiveness from both King Charles and Meghan's father. Also, maybe they should think about explaining more clearly what they are doing and try to be more transparent about their projects and initiatives. Honesty and humility can go a long way.
Thank you, Freya, for sharing your incisive thoughts. This is certainly a topic we will continue to monitor in the future. Please subscribe to the channel to receive notifications and like and share videos to support us. Thank you very much. Goodbye and see you soon, everyone.